Glorious conditions and a big crowd provided an atmosphere to savour at Lord's. And it was Middlesex who got off to a scorching start, with four wickets before lunch. Morris, the first Glamorgan victim, bowled by Philip Tufnell. John Embury struck next, claiming the prize wickets of Matthew Maynard, caught by Cowans, and then the big man himself, Viv Richards. Mike Gatting this time taking the catch, and Richards had scored just 9 runs. The pre-lunch collapse became 86 for 4. Dale caught Embury, bowled Tufnell. After the interval, Croft was next to fall, run out trying to pick up the pace. The hopes of a large Welsh contingent now rested with skipper Alan Butcher, who confidently survived the early wreckage. Angus Fraser was unable to stop Butcher steadily moving towards his century to keep the visitors' hopes alive. And when he finally reached his turn, he received a standing ovation. Butcher finally finished on an unbeaten 104 to set Middlesex a target of 214, a useful recovery from a disastrous start. The Middlesex reply began slowly but surely, before Desmond Haynes made Frost pay with his first boundary. At the other end, Mike Rosebery finally got the score racing along with a huge 6 off Nigel Cowley, the ball disappearing into the building site at the nursery end. The very next ball was dispatched by Rosebery for another boundary, despite a brave attempt by the fielder. But Rosebery succumbed just short of his half century, falling LBW to Adrian Dale on 48. But there was no stopping Haynes, as Cowley was hammered for another 6. And at Team Middlesex were cruising at 92 for 1 off 25 overs. Skipper Mike Gatting, after a cautious start, weighed in with an unbeaten half century, and Haynes too was also unbeaten as Middlesex finally romped home, winning by 9 wickets. John Gubber at Lord's for Thames News.